This is the promised Ripple Energy follow-up video covering in more detail my story of buying into shares of wind turbines. So stay tuned. Let's start right off the bat by stating I'm not a financial advisor. With any kind of investment, do your own research and investigations. I don't really plan to go in depth, a sort of end-to-end explanation of the Ripple share offer, how it works, or what your returns are likely to be if you do invest. You can find all that information on the Ripple Energy's website in the share documentation. There's a link below in the description under this video. So pop and go and have a look at that if that's the level of detail that you're interested in. What I'll cover is why I bought into Ripple, how much I invested, how things have been so far, what information you see on the Ripple dashboard, and how much my first saving payment was from the first wind farm. What is Ripple Energy? It's a cooperative where you buy into part own of a wind farm. You decide how many shares you want to purchase. Your energy supplier buys your share of the wind farm's output at a low operating cost. The turbine's energy is fed into the grid, which means it doesn't matter where you live and how much electricity you use. Savings are credited automatically to your energy bill. If we log on to my Ripple Energy online account, you can see what I can see on my dashboard on the homepage of my account. This is the first turbine, Graig Fatha. Sorry if I've mashed that up. And that went live on the 15th of March, 2022. This dashboard is actually very, very new. It's only a couple of weeks old, as you can imagine, and it is constantly evolving. So new data and graphs are planned to be added here. At the moment, there's just the sort of basic amount of information and data. This particular chart is user specific, so it shows your amount of generation based on the number of shares, or to put it another way, the number of watts you've invested into. We have the news feed here, which is regularly updated with the latest information about a turbine and the Kirkhill project. Scrolling down the page, this will show us Kirkhill. This is the second cooperative wind farm up in Scotland. As you'll see, I've invested in that too. My total ownership is 100% of my electricity needs. So it's 3,978 watts of wind farm purchase. And this is based on our annual electricity consumption of 12,000 kilowatt hours. And that's split between the two locations. So 26% comes from Graig Fatha and 75% from Kirkhill. As you can tell, Graig Fatha was a sort of toe in the water test, whereas with Kirkhill, it was a full jump in and swim about a bit. So here's my wind farm page. My capacity owned, which as you can see there is 3,978 kilowatts, split between the two locations there, as you can see, and the wattage equivalent. The expected annual generation of 12,000 kilowatt hours, split again between the two locations, as you more at Kirkhill, as I've purchased more shares in that, and less at Graig Fatha. Total investment to date, £7,281, and that's again split across those two locations, £5,000 at Kirkhill and £2,000 at Graig Fatha. And I've already mentioned our annual consumption of 12,000 kilowatt hours. So based on that, the savings for Kirkhill, the estimated first year savings rate is 6.40 per kilowatt hour. In the first 12 months, it's £572.96. Again, this is based on what I have invested. Estimated average annual savings is 4.3, estimated annual savings of £384. So that's obviously going to fluctuate year on year over the 25 year period. Graig Fatha first year savings was a princely 9.5. pence per kilowatt hour, and that comes in based on my lower wattage of £293.97. Estimated average annual savings is 5.3, which works at £164. And the Ripple board members aim to pay back the share capital over 20 years at 5% capital each year, or 5% of your capital each year. And as I said a minute ago, the wind farm is expected to have an operational life of 25 years. Okay, so that's the sort of numbers and the stats of my investment. But why did I invest? I guess two reasons, really. We needed a way to cover more of our energy bill going forward and give us some sort of long-term security against price increases. We have solar, as you, most of you all know, but we've actually got no space for any more. And we really needed generation over storage, so you know, additional battery storage wasn't really going to help us very much. So looking around at what other options there weren't that many, to be honest. A house-mounted wind turbine was a choice, but it's never really going to be big enough to make a substantial impact to our generation needs, nor was it ever likely to get planning permission. I also wanted to do our bit for the planet in terms of removing our reliance on gas and support the wind generation projects here in the UK. Moving away from gas means we would use more electricity to heat our home, hence the need to generate more to cover this additional demand. Our first savings that we've just had actually through onto our account. So at the end of March 2022, we saw the first saving applied to our Octopus Energy account automatically from the Graig Fatha. I can never get that name right. From the first wind turbine. If you recall, it went live on the 15th of March at 7 p.m. in the evening, which means 17 days worth of generation. And incidentally, any maintenance costs are already taken off before the savings rate is calculated for members. They reckon the cost to operate the wind farm at Graig Fatha is around 2 pence per kilowatt hour. This is the impressive bit. So during March, Graig Fatha members have saved over £16,000 by generating 342 megawatt hours just in 17 days. If you're technically minded, the type of wind turbine at Graig Fatha is a 2.5 megawatt Vensis 100. Perfect wind conditions for this are between 12 and 24 metres per second. It will cut in and start generating at 3 metres per second wind speed and cut out at 25 metres a second. The Kirk Hill is a bigger wind farm. Craig Thaffer is just one turbine within a wind farm, which is why it's called a wind farm. It's actually only one turbine, but it's part of a bigger wind farm. Whereas Kirk Hill will be 8 wind turbines. They're the Enercon E92 turbines, each rated at 2.350 kilowatts. And they work up from 2 metres a second up to 25 metres a second, so a slightly different profile. If you want to know more, then yeah, have a look at the Ripple Energy's website. There's also an active Facebook group which has postings from the Ripple team members as well as the cooperative members. You don't have to have invested to join that group. I'll leave a link to both of those down below in the description underneath this video. If you do decide to invest, I do have a referral code which you can choose to use if you wish. This will give you £25 credit as well as me £25 credit on our account, providing you invest over £1,000. The share offer, I don't really want to sound like a bank holiday weekend sales spiel here for television advert furniture or anything like that, but the share offer is due to close in early May 2022. Don't hang about if you're deciding you want to go for it. Thanks for watching. I hope this is useful to you and I will see you on the next video. All right. Incidentally, I will be including the monthly savings in my normal solar update videos. So a number of people have asked me about that. So, yeah, there you go. Definitely going now. All right. Take care.